Indications on April the 28th, and I'm with Ivy, one of our banjo boy puppies. Say hello. How are you? He's good. So this month, we decided to dedicate our monthly newsletters to the National Greyhound Adoption Day, which is tomorrow, the 29th of April. And we thought it might be a really good time to share with you some of the activities we do with the greyhounds to ensure they don't only race really well, but they also go on to rehome really well. So an average greyhound will race to its 4.5 years old, give or take, subject to injuries. And then after that period of time, it goes on to be rehomed. And they make the best pets. They are very, very loyal and very compassionate. So it's important when we're rearing them that we take that into consideration and we expose them to all the relevant things that they need to have to be able to be rehomed. So one of the things we look at is socialisation with other animals. So we've got Arnie, who lives with us on farm, who spends a fair bit of time walking around. And then we've obviously got our own children, and then we have many visitors come up like yourselves. It's really important as owners and breeders we take that responsibility very seriously because we need the industry to survive, and without rehoming these animals that does put that at risk. Now we had some exciting news this week, and that's about the muzzle. So as from the 1st of January 2019, a non-racing greyhound no longer needs to wear the muzzle in public. Now Ivy, obviously not the 19th of June, January, but Ivy will be wearing her muzzle because she's going to be a racer, so she is in the progress of being trained, so she will keep that on. But as soon as she's finished retiring, she doesn't have to wear it, so that's great. Now one of the other things that's really important about rehoming is exposing them to different environments. So as you can imagine, a greyhound in a greyhound farm spends a lot of time in a paddock, running up and down. There's lots happening at the farm. We play with them with toys and things, but there's also an element of environmental experience that they need to be exposed to. So in January you would have noticed that we took Ivy to the beach from the newsletter that you're seeing there, and today what we've done is we've brought her down to the park so that she's exposed to different noises, different sounds. It's something really easy for me to do as a mum. I can just bring the kids and it helps Stephen out. It gives them exposure to the trailer, so they go in and out and they get used to travelling. It gives them exposure to having a muzzle on, which is something that they wouldn't normally do in a rearing paddock. So I'll just take Ivy for a little walk round, show her around the park and let her have a little sniff. She's already had a bit of a play already with us this morning. Other than this, she's in really good condition. Her leg length's come up really nicely. She's had a bit of a growth spurt this month, so we're happy with that. And she's on track to head to the breakers in July. So everything else is all good. No problem. So we'll take a little wander round. Come on.